guys, it's Slave to the Games, and we're back with the next Bloodlines 2 / World of Darkness video, and this time we're going to be covering Demons due to popular vote. As always, thanks guys for choosing to hang out with me and for sticking around. Demons are the main characters and titular supernatural creatures of Demon the Fallen. They are fallen angels who chose to side with Lucifer and humanity rather than with God in the first days of creation. As punishment for their rebellion and disloyalty, the Archangel Michael cast these angels out of heaven and into the abyss. Many, especially those who fear or revile them, refer to them as the Fallen or the Damned. The Elohim were responsible for the creation of everything, including humanity. However, God had special orders for them. The Elohim were to watch over humans, but never make themselves known. The war in heaven began when an angel named Arimal, one of the Nebiru, foresaw a disaster in the future, a disaster which God had either directly orchestrated or would allow to happen. The angels debated whether or not to act against God in order to prevent this disaster. Many argued that it would be safer to do nothing, because their action could potentially be the cause of the disaster. The angel Lucifer was the first to make a conclusive decision in favor of rebellion, and he became the leader of the rebel angels. One third of the angels sided with Lucifer and tried to prepare humanity for the impending catastrophe by accelerating its development. These fallen revealed themselves to humanity in order to bring them the light of knowledge and awareness. In so doing, they incurred the wrath of God, who had given humanity the potential to be aware of the word, the good and evil, yet had not intended man to have this kind of awareness yet. The first of humans, Adam and Eve, had been given gifts that they could not use due to their initial innocence. A child is happy because he's unaware, right? In the games, Adam and Eve are portrayed as having had only rudimentary knowledge and awareness, solely concerned with their survival. During the war that followed, the sin of Cain taught the fallen how to kill, and many grew twisted and evil. For this transgression against the creator's wishes, the fallen were cast out from heaven and creation was devastated. After a lengthy, increasingly atrocious war with the loyalist Elohim over the fate of humanity, the fallen were finally defeated when the Babel Project failed and severed the link between the fallen and the humans. The defeated and former Elohim were cast into the abyss and lingered there for untold eons. In the end, Arimal's vision was true. By abandoning God and misleading humanity, the rebel Elohim caused it to become a shade of what it was meant to be. Then, the walls of abyss cracked during the sixth great maelstrom, and the fallen started escaping back to the material world. As spiritual beings, the fallen need an anchor to the physical world if they wish to remain there. Continue existing, a demon must find a suitable host for itself. Bodies with weak souls, for example, comatose patients, severe drug addicts, or suicidal people. The demon severs the weakened soul from the body and takes its place inside the host, merging with the host's memories and emotions, and continues existence on Earth to follow its own personal agenda. While the mortal body provides the fallen with a shield against the full memory of their torment in hell, they are sometimes hindered by the memories and feelings the mortal soul left behind. This is in part too because while they still are themselves in terms of their soul, they are also at the same time the person they took over. Those who take a soulless human host become the true fallen, while those whose existence has greatly degraded that they can only reside in inanimate objects become the earthbound. A human host has the disadvantage of being unable to hold all the fallen's memories, and also only allows a trickle of power compared to what the fallen used to be able to accomplish. On the upside, however, the lingering memories and values of some hosts can restore the fallen to sanity and help them restore and nourish their faith after their long imprisonment. As their mortal hosts are already possessed in a manner of speaking, it is almost impossible for a fallen's host to be possessed by another. However, especially strong acts of will may be able to push a demon out, in which case they must find another host or be returned to the abyss. Demons can have three names: the name given to their human form, the celestial name, which is what other demons tend to know them as, and the true name, which is abstract and utterly unspeakable by mortal tongues. Some fallen go so far as to shed their mortal name when they gain enough power and memory to re-establish their fallen identity. Despite also being condemned by God, the vast majority of the children of Cain, or vampires, want little to do with the forces of hell. Many fear to offend the god who cursed their dark father, while others simply are too proud or smart to align with demons. In all major sects and clans, infernalism is a major crime punishable by final death. The Sabbat consider it a heinous crime. To bow to a demon is the same as bowing to an ancient. But as I mentioned in the previous video, some vampires are convinced that they are damned and monsters, getting tempted to walk a darker path than even the average horror that a vampire endures. Some secretly follow the path of evil revelations, abandoning their humanity and devotion to the forces of darkness. darkness. Even more so, some Saba and other vampires practice the discipline of dark thaumaturgy, turning into demons for power, becoming in effect thralls. Most vampires ruthlessly persecute the Bali clan, and they must hide in secret unless they wish to risk final death. Still, many kindred are tempted by demonic powers, particularly those who feel that since they are already damned, they have nothing to lose if they align with demons. However, many kindred and clans and sects all actively take up the fight against such creatures. And with that, guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you did enjoy it or learn something new. If you didn't, then please comment below, tell me what I could help further explain on, or just other, well, subjects you want me to cover. Don't forget to also, optionally, check out my Patreon and my merch store to help further support me in what I do. I'm 6 away from reaching my 10 goal Patreon membership. And then also think about joining my Discord in the link below so that you can talk to me in between stream hours and video releases. You guys have a nice day. I'm signing off. I hope you guys have a great day too.